Hello everyone, in this video we're going to see the solution to the code horses problem B subsequence 8. So this is problem B of code horses round 646 division 2, and this problem or the implementation in this problem was very similar to the problem changes in a string of hacker at April circuits. Here we have 1100, and in this problem we had A's and B's, so the implementation part is exactly the same as this problem of hacker at. But there's one more twist in this. So let's just look at the question. So we have a binary string, meaning that it will only have 0 or 1. And we can, in one operation, we can select one index and we can flip it, meaning that we can select 0 and turn into 1, or we can select 1 or turn into 0. Now, we want our string to be good. And a string is called good if it does not contain 010 or 101 as a subsequence. Not a substring, but as a subsequence. So 1001 has 101, so it's not a good string. 100 doesn't have, so likewise we have some examples, and we have to make our string good with the minimum number of operations. So let's just look at some examples. So you can see that if I do this, this is not a good string. Why? Because I have 101, I have 010, and I have 1001. So if I remove this 0, still I have 101. If I remove this 0, we still have 101. If I remove this 0, we still have 1001. So we'll have to change that. So what is a good string? Let's just focus on that. Let's forget about making our string into a good string, but focus on what is a good string. So the good, and this is the only observation that you had to do. Afterward, it's just an implementation problem. So what will be a good string? If I have 000, meaning if I have only zeros, it's a good string. If I have only one, it's a good string. If I have one followed by zeros, meaning that any number of one followed by any number of zeros, it's a good string. If I have any number of zeros followed by any number of one, it's a good string. So these are the only conditions of a good string. Any other form, it won't be a good string. So if your string is in the form all zeros, all ones, some ones followed by some zeros, or some zeros followed by some ones, they will be good. So these are good strings. So whatever string you have to make them into any of this form, and whichever form takes minimum operations will do, will make it into that form. So how do we calculate about making, about turning into this form? So let's just say I have 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now, as I said, I can turn it into any of those forms. So I can either turn into zeros followed by 1, followed by 1, or 1s followed by zeros. So let's focus on the first part. So I want to make this into zeros followed by 1. So first, let's look at some, how many positions it has. Positions as in, so I have 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So the positions are, I'll just mark them, this, 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 and this. So I have this string, and I have to make it into zeros followed by ones. So we can have some zeros and then some ones, or we can have no zero and all ones. So all ones is being fulfilled here, all one condition. All ones will be satisfied here, will be covered here. Let's just say all ones will be covered here also. Okay, so we're just calculating how many operations will we have to take to make this in the form zeros followed by one. So we have, for n, we have n plus one positions. For length n, we have n plus one positions, like I have marked by a dot. Now, at this position, if I turn everything on the left into 0, and from this position, if I turn everything in the right into 1, and I calculate how many operations will that take me, then I have my answer for this position, which will be, which will turn into 1, 1, 1, 1, all 1s. Now, I come to this position, and I calculate how many operations will it take me to turn everything on the left to 0, and to turn everything on the right to 1. Likewise, I come to this position and I calculate how many operations will it take me to convert everything on the left to 0 and everything on the right to 1. So how many will it actually take me? So let's just say, if I'm turning everything on the left to zero, so how much will it take me at each point? So at this point, turning everything on the left to zero, we have nothing, so zero. Then at this point, turning everything on the left to zero, so we have already 1, 0, we don't need to turn anything, so zero. Now I come to this point and I have to turn everything on the left of this string into zero. So we have 1, 1, we will have to turn that, so it will take me 1. And then I come here and everything on the left I have to turn into 0. So we only have 1, so 1. Now I come to this position and everything on the left I have to turn into 1. I have to turn into 0. So we have 2 ones, we'll have to turn them. So this will be 2. I come to this position, everything on the left I have to turn into 0. So, and I have 2 ones, so it will just be 2 again. And here, the changes I have to make on the left will be 3. So at every point to convert everything on the left into zeros. Now I'll calculate how many will it take me to convert everything on the right into 1. So let's just see that. So I'll just come from the back, so it will be easy. Now everything on the right I'm here changing into 1s. So on the right there's nothing, so in this position it will take me 0. Okay, now come to this position and everything on the right I'm turning into 1. So we already have a 1, so no problem, so it will be 0. Now come to this position, everything on the right I'm turning to 1, so 0. And I come here, everything on the right I have to turn into 1, and I have 1, 0, I'll have to change that, so 1. I come here and everything on the right I'm changing into 1, but we only have 1, 0, so we'll have to change that, so 1. Now again, from here, everything on the right I have to change into 1, and so it will be 2 changes. So these are the 2 strings I have for the number of operations of turning everything in the left into 0 and everything on the right into 1 at each position. Now let's look at collectively from both of our values. So at this point, if I turn everything on the left to 0 and everything on the right to 1 together, then how many operations will it take me? 0 plus 2. At this point, if I turn everything on the right and the left to 0 and everything on the right to 1, how many changes will it take me? 0 plus 1. Likewise, from this position, everything on the left I'm changing into 0 and everything on the right I'm changing into 1. So how many operations will that take me? 1 plus 1. So if I name this array pre1, say pre1, and if I name this array pre2, then pre1 of I plus pre2 of I is telling me changes, or say operations required to make it in form 0011, such from left of I it's zeros and on the right of I it's 1, it's 0 and right of I it's 1. So that's it, we just calculate pre1 plus pre2, then we calculate this plus this, and we calculate this plus this, and whatever is the minimum is the minimum. So minimum of this, I'll just say minimum of this minimum, let's just write it like this. So minimum of pre1 plus pr1 plus pr1 of I plus pr2 of I, the minimum value will tell me minimum operation to change it in the form 0011, the zeros followed by 1. So I'll just write dot. So zeros followed by 1s. Now, this is, and let's show this in min1. So the minimum will be in min1. So min1 will be minimum operation to change, minimum operations to change in this form. 0011. Now we have to calculate for 1100. So for 1100, what do? We do the same thing, but in this case we just check on the left how many operations we have to do to make it into 0, and on the right how many operations we did 0 followed by 1. So now we have to change. So for 1100 we do the same thing, but here we check on the left how many changes will we have to make it into all ones, and on the right how many changes will we have to make it into all zeros. So how is this happening? For the implementation part, it is simple. For the first thing, I have a loop from 0 to n, and I'm counting the number of ones because I'm changing it into zeros. So the number of ones I have to change into zeros. And here I'm going from the back and I'm counting the number of zeros, because the number of zeros I have to turn into one. So that's all. Now let's get to the implementation part. So this is my code. So here you can see that I've just taken in the string, and here I'm making it into the form 0011. So I have two array, PR1 and PR2, like I just said, and I have count1 and count0. So I'm filling PR1 by just counting 1, because those 1s I have to change into zeros, and I'm filling PR2 by counting zeros, because those zeros I have to change into 1. Then I'm counting the minimum of PR1 plus PR2y, and I'm showing that into minimum 1. Then I'm doing the same thing, exact same thing, to convert it into 1100, and the minimum of that I'm showing into minimum 2, and then finally I'm outputting the minimum of min1 and min2. So that's all for the implementation part. And the question is very, very similar to Hacker at April Circuits 2020 changes in a string. You can look at that if you want. And so that's all. Thank you.